Let's play some Mega Man X. Hold on, just making sure everything looks good. Alright. So this is the Mega Man X Legacy Collection on PS4. So I played the original 4. I've also played 2 and 3. So, nothing special here, just playing and getting hit. Hi Jawa, how's it going? Kind of a last minute impromptu stream. I just got the Legacy Collection for PS4. I thought I'd play through them. Bit late here. It's been a while. It's about 11:17 here in New York at this time. So, I actually have this on my 3DS, Mega Man X, X2, and X3. I've played a few of the others before, I think, but that was a very long time ago, and I don't remember much of anything about them. And I never completed any of them, except for the first three, which I have on DS. Alright, have a good lunch. What's on the menu? If you don't mind sharing. Now it's time for this, an unwinnable fight. Practically, you don't have to do anything here. Yeah, you gotta make it look good, though, right? Well, look who's running away. Not yet. Save game? Sure, why not? Alright. I probably should do Chill Penguin first. Definitely not that one. Yeah, not as well. I know. It's got the speed boosts. Yeah. Speed boost will be nice. Ooh, extra life. Those are always good. I'll probably need them at some point. Hey, get back here. Nope. Up you go. Oh, this one's not very well hidden. It's actually mandatory. Well, now I can dash. Go for a ride. Whoa. Alright, so going into the boss battle with almost full health. Chill Penguin. And of course he blocks my first shot. How do you like that? Thank you. And that, as they say, is that. I think if you're playing this for the first time, Chill Penguin is definitely the stage to go. Definitely the easiest of the bosses, in my opinion. Especially the easiest one with the Mega Buster. The X-Buster, I should say. Alright, Shell Penguin's down. I can get the... Normally I do this one later, but... Yeah, why the hell not? I'll get the armor. Alright. I usually don't do this one this early. I usually go to Storm Eagle next. So, key for this thing, aim for the head. And keep away from that little drill. That little claw. And this thing has lots of health. You know you're about halfway done when you start smoking. Particularly difficult, just long and annoying. Alright, so if you can see that little puff of smoke, means you're about halfway done. And that is that. So now I have new and improved armor. Help, because this particular boss is challenging if you don't have its weakness. The stage boss is challenging if you don't have its weakness. Almost went in the pit there. That would have sucked. Health. Extra life. Oh yeah, that's right, I have shotgun ice. Thank you. that helps me get through the stage without full health. Let's charge up here. And let's go for Sting Chameleon. Think we'll just watch for the ceiling. The ceiling hurts ya. So don't climb up too high on the walls. That attack sucks. That's hard to dodge all of those little things. Didn't think I'd be doing this well. Watch now that I say that. Speed kills. Almost. Three bars left. Gotcha. The armor helped, otherwise I would have died. Especially near the end. And that Sting Chameleon. Oh, forgot to... Alright, let's go with Storm Eagle. Storm Eagle's a pretty easy boss, too. As long as you have the speed boots, Storm Eagle's not too bad. Hi. Did you have a good lunch? Here's the first of the health upgrades. So I beat Chill Penguin stage and the Sting Chameleon stage. I've got the dash power and the armor now. That's what you missed. Come on. Now I'm doing Storm Eagle. Alright. Ooh, an extra life. Also got my first sub-tank. If you don't know how sub-tanks work, whenever you're at full health and you collect some health, they'll go into the sub-tank. And whenever you're low on health, you can go into your sub-tanks and give yourself a nice little boost. There's four sub-tanks total to be found. Have this game and that's okay. You don't have to like a game. You don't have to be good at a game. You just have to like it. For instance, I like playing StarCraft, but I am terrible at it. But of course, the more you play it, the better you get. Because I was terrible at this game, but then after playing it for a while, I started to get a little bit better. But even now, I'm nowhere close to the pros. And that's the helmet upgrade. Helmet upgrade, not really all that useful, except for getting the fourth armor part, which I'll probably go for next. Another extra life. Brings me up to 6. That's okay. I haven't played the original Mega Mans that much. Just the X version. X 1, 2, and 3, mostly. Down the ladder. Now, I know I have this guy's weakness, but I'm gonna try the Buster only for right now. Keep things all interesting. Hi! Having the dash power really helps with this guy. Also, in this game, if you dash and charge, it actually boosts up your basic shot a little bit. 2. See, does 1 point of damage, but if you're dashing, it'll do 2. Little trick I picked up while reading the internet. Not sure if it's intended or not, but there you go. Storm Tornado, it's one of my favorite moves in the game. Thank you. Alright. Well, let's see. I got Storm Eagle. Got Sting. Now let's go to Flame Mammoth. Might as well get the fourth and final armor upgrade as well. Also, if you beat Kill Penguin stage, it makes a few changes on this stage. Turns the floor from lava to ice, making it safe to walk on. So if you don't beat Chill Penguin stage, the floor would actually hurt you. The floor would be lava and it'd hurt you. And now I can just dash under everything. This jump is pretty tricky right here. Very easy to mess up. Almost had it. Yep. There's a few other stages that do that too, like beating Storm Eagle's stage changes Spark Mandrill, which I'll get to later, and beating the Octopus stage. Come on. Okay. Don't fall down, don't fall down. Yeah, falling down would suck. You'd have to exit the level and re-enter it again. So this will basically give your main attack fourth power up when he turns pink. You can also charge up your other weapons. Pink. And if you don't get this upgrade here, you actually get it automatically during the final four levels of the game. So if you miss that one, you can still get it. So that one's guaranteed later on. But I might as well get it now. There's a heart container. So yeah, if the floor was lava, getting a heart container... it's possible to get it with the floor is lava, but you need a higher health bar and use invincibility frames and all that other fun stuff. I think it's just easier to beat Shell Penguin, a fairly easy boss. There's an extra life. And if you don't have the dash boots, you can't break these blocks. So you can get that with the dash boots, but you need the helmet in order to get the power up. I forgot I had this power. I think the Storm Eagle power is probably the best one in the game. Whoops. Didn't mean to hit the button. So powerful. So cheap. And I love it. It also happens to be this boss's weakness. Also, the floor on this one kind of moves. Hello, Flame Mammoth. Now he's growling at me. Gotcha. I won't do as well when I get to Mega Man X4, which I've played only very, very little of, and that was a long time ago. And of course, and 5, 6, 7, and 8 as well. Alright. Firewave. Save. Yep, it's a close one. Well, I did enter the stage with less health, too. The boss part with a little less health. Less than 4. So, you're thinking, why are you in this stage? You already cleared it. Well, I'll show you that once I get to a certain point. There's a secret heart later on, and you can't get it without the fire weapon from Flame Mammoth. So until you beat Flame Mammoth, you can't get the heart. Because each stage has a heart upgrade, which increases your max health. And I want them all. Alright. Kind of cheesed that one a little bit, but that's okay. See, you can only destroy these with the fire wave. Alright, since I finished the level, I can just exit out right now. Alright, so I've got everything in there, got everything there, got everything there. Need the heart container there, but I can't do it until I do that stage. Let's see. What do I want to do? Let's do Boomerang Kawanger. I don't have his weakness, but... I don't have his weakness, but I can still do the stage. Yeah, like they said, the tornado power is OP. Have a good day in Australia. It's night here in New York, but have a good day in Australia. Alright. Dispatch those real quick. And we ride the elevator. Facing the right way. I can usually get that one, no problem. I usually get that. Normally you're supposed to have the boomerang power. There we go. But you can actually get it with the... if you have the arm upgrade. I think it might even be possible without it, but I haven't been able to do that part. Just the boots. I think it's possible to do it with just the boots. I think I might have seen a speedrunner do that. But I can't do that. At least right, not right now. Not without a heck of a lot of practice. That's a conveniently placed health upgrade. I mean, up health up. Alright. Alright. Boomerang Kawanger. While you do that, I'll stay up here. Go ahead and do that. I'll stay up here. I love the dash shooting thing. Not sure if it's intentional or not, but... Stay still. Pretty devastating in pink trophy. My guess is that's for beating him with the fully charged X Buster shot. Alright, let's consider that one. Spark Mandro. The sub-tank in here, there is a sub-tank in here, you actually need the Boomerang Kawanger power in order to get it. Also, if you complete Storm Eagle stage, you'll see ruins. And the stage will also go dark. Somewhat, in a little bit here. See, that's what... Also, the floor, normally there's like little sparks on those little, the glass part I'm standing on. So, without the missile base from Storm Eagle stage, just harmless. Tornado power is so good. Now time for a mini boss. The mini boss is actually pretty tough unless you have Storm Eagle's power. Then it's just really easy with Storm Eagle's power. Otherwise, it's a little annoying. Whoops. Hey, not fair. Another health upgrade. It's gonna be like 7 lives. A little bit of health. So, this is the boss, Spark Mandrill. He's actually extremely easy if you have his weakness. But I'm going to give it a shot with just the X-Buster first. And if that fails, well, I got his weakness. Didn't open the pause menu up quick enough. I was gonna use my sub tank. Right. I'll give it one more shot. I know of an easy way to grind lives, anyways. Like I said, he's really easy with the shotgun ice power, but I want to try it with the X-Buster. When I fight him again, I'll use shotgun ice, and you'll see just how really easy that guy is. Save, yes. So I got two left. Let's do Armored Armadillo. So, in my opinion, Armored Armadillo is the hardest boss if you don't have its weakness. If you have its weakness, it's fairly manageable. This is also a good place to fill up your sub tank and get lives. These bats are very easy to kill and very easy to respawn. And they have decent drop rates of this stuff. Three sub tanks to fill. So, this particular bat enemy that I just killed, that actually has a very high drop rate of extra lives. And the most slides you can hold is 9, so I'll get one more. So he has a... So if you need extra lives, this is the stage you want to go to, because that bat has a very good drop rate. I just don't recommend coming here until you get... Till you beat Spark Mandrill. So the sub tank's coming up. What you want to do is you want to get that started, quickly climb up, let it do its thing, and there's your final sub tank. So it removes top of the walls, which means I can't get up there, but that's okay. I can get more of these later anyways. Took a hit there. And there. Come here. Don't want them dropping it over the spikes. Because that would hurt. Let's see, it's about halfway there. Two-thirds of the way. I know, not very exciting, but it's gotta get done. Alright. So here, you can actually... If you're careful, you can get in front of this. Now, if you get behind it, it's okay. You can use the flamethrower. Point is, if you don't kill it quickly enough, you can't get up there. Also, I believe those spikes from it are instant kill, so stay far in front of it. So, if you get everything, this is where you'll find the Hadouken upgrade up there. But I don't have everything. You have to find all the hearts, defeat all the bosses, all the armor parts, and have all sub-tanks. Now, I have... I'm gonna do something really foolish. This boss will out. Normally, I don't try to do this Buster only. Is it hidden? And I died. So yeah, this boss is tough because of his armor. But let's see. Let's fix that, shall we? Just plain Dillo. See how much easier it is with its weakness? So much easier with its weakness. Because without it, you can't hit him. It's very hard to hit him. Because his armor. But with the electric upgrade, electric spark, his armor comes off very easy. Alright. So let's just, launch Octopus. It's the only one left. And after Launch Octopus, we'll get the final heart. The heart container, you're gonna want to take this up. So you want to destroy that. Tornado is OP. And once you defeat that, you get this stage's heart upgrade. Spikes are instant kill, and I don't know why I did that. Alright. Coming out. Tornado is OP. Alright. So this boss's weakness is the rolling shield. But I want to get the boomerang power out first, and you'll see why in just a bit. And that is Long Octopus, the final boss. The final stage boss. Just want to hit him a couple times with the boomerang power, and it'll take off his, his arms, and it'll make him a lot easier. Severely limits the number of attacks. That, as they say, is that. No more Lunch Octopus. But we're still not done yet. So before we go there, we're going to go here. Because until you beat Launch Octopus, you're not supposed to be able to get the stage's heart container. I think it might be possible without it, but I haven't been able to do it. And I got a trophy for getting all the hearts. Alright, so I'm fully powered up. I'm gonna go back to this stage so I can get Hadouken. And if you're not familiar, it's a secret upgrade that, if you're at full health, you can perform a move that one hit kills anything except the final boss. That includes even the other Mavericks, the stage bosses. See, you can actually get up there now. But I don't really need it right now. Sure, you have to have full health in order to get Hadouken. Alright. So if you end up behind this thing, you want to get to the firepower. That'll easily destroy it. Otherwise, I don't think you'll be able to destroy it with the X-Buster in time. But, since I already got the heart... Ooh, that was close. That was close. So, I know you have to do this a certain number of times before it appears. I Well, that time I messed up, but I think you have to reach that platform a certain number of times before it unlocks the Hadouken power. You don't need the Hadouken to finish the game, I just want it. Because, why not? Right? Up again. Three lives left. Ugh. That was me. That was me. That was me being terrible. Alright. That's what happens when you're not careful. There we go. Now I know Hadouken's like in another game or something. It's like a little reference. You gotta push down, down forward, and then it only works at full health. And it can one-hit kill anything except the final stage 3 of the final boss. Alright. Alright. Alright, let's do this. This part's fun. Well, having the torpedo selected helps with those enemies. Oh, I thought I was dead there. Homing torpedoes, they home in. They home in, and you don't have to jump and aim, helping you stay on the platforms. A little bit of cheese there. Thank you. So just like before, this next part, you can't win. You just have to let them lower your health. Gotta let them wail on you. And don't worry, your health will be fully restored. Almost had it. So if you can't do Hadouken, Rolling Shield is what you want to use. Now, at this point, if you do not have the armor, the arm parts from the Flame Animus stage, you will get them from him. And this dialogue is also slightly different. He'll say, "Take my power," and something like that. You get a slightly different dialogue because if I found the arm parts already. Boost my health, which is always good. So this should be Boomerang Kawanger. I'm gonna want Homing Torpedo. This is his weakness. Nice, I'm gonna need that. Okay. this boss is a little annoying, the spider boss. Weakness is shotgun ice. Use a sub tank here pretty soon. Whoops. To do the Hadouken. That was pretty foolish. I hate this. Probably my least favorite boss right here is this one. Mess up, there's no way to recover your weapon energy. Oh, this moves too damn fast. Not when I'm this close. I don't have a choice. I'm down to one shot left. Really don't like that one. All right. Save absolutely. All right. Time to refill my tanks. Accidentally did a Hadouken. Okay. extra life. Those are always good. Six. Like I said, that has a very high chance of dropping extra lives. So if you need lives and you've already beaten this stage, you know where to go. I believe this is Armored Armadillo? Nope, Chill Penguin. And why the heck didn't I use Hadouken again? Because I'm not used to it. Wow, I didn't think he'd be doing his breath attack that quickly. Oh, that breath attack gets me every time. He's not that hard. I'm just playing really, really badly right now. That was extremely pathetic. So I can get up the fucking ladder. Sorry. There we go. Storm Eagle.
least Storm Eagle's one of the easier ones. One of the easy ones. Stage boss. I forget what this thing's weak to. I think it's that? Yeah, I was at low health anyway, so... Pro tip, don't touch the spikes. And what do? I touch the spikes. I'm low on weapons energy. So you actually have to destroy all three of those components. Well, not as bad as the spider one. I hate the spider one. Time to use a sub-tank. It should be one of them, at least one of them should be pretty close to being destroyed by now. One and a half health bars, but I did it. Alright, I'll refill my sub tanks later. So much for Hadouken. Alright, armored. It's actually possible to skip this fight. Where's the fun in that? Plus, I'm not sure how to do it. And he's gone. Let's just get to the boss. Alright, stop trying to be clever. Let's just end this. It's like real easy once you get them into that pattern. I was trying to get fancy, but there's no reason to get fancy. Alright, so this will show you just how easy this is with the weakness. Wait until his arms go down, then fire. Put a little bit of distance between you. Like I said, pathetically easy with the shotgun ice. Might be able to Hadouken this. Might be able to Hadouken this thing. Try Hadouken. Nope. Invincibility frames. Satisfying. Next up should be Flame Mammoth. It's actually possible to cut off a snout. But I didn't have enough tornado cutting power. Which, and it just so happens that the final boss is weak to cutting power. And there's no way to recharge it. I did that one to myself. Now this boss is terribly difficult. Keep hitting that button. Why do I keep doing that? Now time for the final stage. But before we do the final stage, let's fill up. Chances are I'm going to need all four sub-tanks in the final stage. Alright. We're filled up. 8 lives. Alright, we're filled up. Alright, final stage. Let's do this. Alright. Here we go. Three phases. So you gotta face the dog, which is weak to ice. But I messed up Hidoken. And I'm taking a lot of damage. So this next phase is weak to electric spark. That's okay. First death. I still have all four of my sub-tanks. This could be going better. Alright. Now, Hidoken will not work on the final boss. This part, this phase of the boss. Alright, might as well use my sub tank now. Where is, rolling shield is what you want for this. I wish I would stop doing that. Gonna be close. Oh, damn it. all out of sub tanks too. It's actually pretty easy, if not time-consuming. That's two sub-tanks down. I'm pretty sure all my weapons are charged up, too. Three tanks down. All right. Sorry, didn't mean to do that that time. Alright. Alright. Gotcha. Messed up. That's okay. Don't have to. Don't have to fill up this time. Set up. Damn it. already seen this text. Hard to predict where he's gonna go. Come on, do your thing. Wall jump. Fully powered shot would have gotten him. Well, I can't use Hadouken on the next part, so. Just gotta take my time and not make mistakes. This time, I got two full sub tanks. That was me being bad player. Alright. Now it's time to refill. Yes, I'm actually at the very last stage. You missed a couple failures. Right now I'm refilling my energy in sub tanks. Not very exciting, but it's gotta get done. Two tanks left to go. At least all my weapons are fully charged now. Yes, I do know Hadouken. I used it a couple times against the dog boss, but I haven't been able to get it to work against phase 2. And of course, phase 3 it won't work at all. Fully powered. Ready to do this again. If at first you don't succeed, try again.
seen this dialogue before. Yes, yes, yes. La la la, la la la, la la la. Don't care, don't care, don't care. Alright. Ah, keep hitting that button. Hey, I managed to do it that time. Alright, so phase one was easy. Ah, invincibility. It's invincibility frames. Lightsaber. You know, this actually is going a lot better than my previous attempts. Usually I've used a sub-tank by now. Of course, the other side... The other time I was fighting on the other side... This might be the better. Alright. Gotcha. Alright. And I go to the final phase with four sub-tanks. That's kind of awesome. Final fight. Here we go. Right. Rolling shield. Because that's the weakness. Alright. I'm gonna use the sub tank now. Because why not? Oh, I wasn't paying attention to my health. Plus, when I hit the pause button, it didn't do anything. Alright, here we go again. At least this time I only have one tank to fill instead of three. Right? Yep. Three or four tanks. So close. Okay, all my weapons are refilled. I was just waiting on the health. Oh, an extra life. Alright, there we go. Up we go. So hopefully I time this right. So I can skip the first phase, perhaps even the second phase. Here we go. Time that perfectly. Alright.
didn't quite get it. Quite up to full health, so. Gotcha. All right. Phase two down again. Let's try to get through phase three this time. Shield. Ow. All right, sub tank time. Tank time again. Better to use it now than not use it at all. And that's game. Whew. Trophy, it's over. Where is that one? Where's the one I want? Hours. It took me 2 hours to do it. So, well, not for now, but next time, we'll play some Mega Man X 2. Now, I've played that one on my 3DS, so I know the secrets of that one, too, so. But for now, let's just enjoy the credits. Just a listing of the Mavericks I defeated. Thinking of streaming Final Fantasy 15? Well, that's cool. I have it, but I haven't played much of it. For some reason, I haven't played much of it. Been too busy doing other stuff. Vile? Sigma? Zero? And you as Mega Man X. Well, I think that'll do it for now. Thanks for watching. Next time we'll be doing Mega Man X2. Until then, hope you have a fantastic night or day.